Welcome back to my channel. So today's tutorial, I'm gonna be showing you how to create this super inexpensive bench. It is so inexpensive and it is so cute. And it's super customizable too, because I do know people will say, oh, my weight's not gonna fit on that bench, or my butt won't fit on that bench, because I've heard that before when I made the stool. You can always use a bigger board. You can use more crates. The main point of my videos is to inspire you guys. So, you know, you don't have to do it exactly the way that I did, but hopefully it inspires you to create something similar, and at least it's kind of like a guide. I know it's easy to be a little bit skeptical because you just see two small little wooden crates, but it does hold quite a bit of weight. If you are a little skeptical, if you go to the craft store, just lay down the crates, sit on top of them, and see what happens. So I hope you guys enjoyed this really simple tutorial. If you do, please make sure you give it a thumbs up. Let's see if we can get this video to 3,000 likes. Also, make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel so you'll be notified every single time that I upload. With that being said, let's begin the video.
Okay, you're gonna need some unfinished crates for this. The cheapest place to get them is at John Fabrics, because you can use coupons with the crates. Unlike Michael's, they do have them for $10, still inexpensive, but you cannot use any coupons with it. If you wait till Joann Fabrics has their 60% off coupons, you can get this for as little as $5.20. Walmart also has them for $9.97. All of these places sell them still for relatively cheap. It's just best to go to Joann Fabrics. Save your coin, girl. Time to spray paint. What I'm gonna be using to spray paint is a white paint, and it has a flat finish to it. I didn't want anything shiny. So you can sand this down so that the spray paint adheres better to it, but I didn't want to. I didn't want my crate to be perfectly opaque. I wanted a little bit of that distressed look to it. I personally like that style better when it comes to these crates. So don't get me wrong, they were still pretty white, but there was a little bit of that natural wood color kind of peeking through. For each crate, I sprayed one layer of paint, wait for it to dry, and then I sprayed another layer. It's best to do it that way, because if you try to apply too much paint at once, it's gonna start dripping down. Now for the top of this, I wanted to make it super easy. I wanted to get something that you can just go into the store, buy, and you're good to go without having to paint it or get it cut down. So I'm just gonna be using a traditional finished board. These type of boards, they usually use them for shelving. I got my board from Menards, and I chose the board that was thicker rather than the thinner one, even though they're not that big of a difference. I just rather have the thicker one, and that one only cost me $7.48. It is 3 feet long. Okay, I'm not gonna be drilling or nailing my board in place. I literally just put this thing on top of the crates. Of course, you can nail it, screw it in place, but I do know a lot of you guys prefer something easier. So what you can do is get wood glue and just glue both of the crates to each other. I'm totally pretending to put glue on this right now. I'm just trying to show you basically what you're supposed to do, but it's pretty self-explanatory. And you can clamp this in place if you have a clamp. You don't really need one. I'm just using these like clips that I got from Dollar Tree. This just makes sure that the crates are really tight and touching each other. Then you'll apply glue to the top of the crates down every row of wood. Then you place your board on top. You gotta decide if you want it to just be centered smack dab in the middle of the crate, so a little bit of the board is sticking out in the front and in the back, or if you want it to be just sticking out in the back or just in the front. So I had the board sticking out in the front so that the crates would lie flat on my wall. And then all you got to do is wait for the glue to dry and you're good to go. But for me, it was as easy as putting the board on top of the crate. Now here's some random footage of me and my sister sitting on top of the bench. We decided to try bouncing on the bench to see if it would break, and it didn't break, so it does hold quite a bit of weight, like I said.
So that's it for the bench tutorial. I do want to talk a little bit about the items that you see, especially in the beginning footage, because lots of times the items that I use as props, I get lots of questions on. So first of all, the really fluffy, nice, soft white pillows, I got them in a two-pack, so it was two for $16.99 from Marshalls. These really pretty storage boxes, I got them at Hobby Lobby. They're 50% off right now, so this one was originally $3, so I got it for $1.50, and then the bigger box is originally $6, and I got it for $3. These white throws, I got at Five Below for $5. I also have a few that I got at Marshalls for $12.99 and $16.99. The mason jar was from Dollar Tree, and then the flowers were from Michael's. They're originally priced at $10, but I got them for $4 when they had a 60% off coupon code. Finally, this reindeer head that I keep getting so many questions about is from Michael's, but the only thing is it's from their Christmas collection. So I'm not positive you're gonna be able to find this right now at your Michael's, just because it is a clearance item, but near where I live. So that's it for the tutorial. Again, I hope you guys enjoyed it. Don't forget to hit that thumbs up and let me know down in the comments below if you have any crate ideas for me. I'm gonna let you guys go. Thank you so much for watching. Take care, bye.